finished goods is known as industries. Raw material is basically transformed to the manufacturing processes. Manufacturing processes are used for a transformation of raw material into finished goods. Finished goods. So industry is a place where raw material transformed into the finished goods is known as the industry. So manufacturing and industry both are the different things. The place where the manufacturing processes are used for transformation of raw material into the finished goods. And the manufacturing processes are those ways through which raw material, it is used for a consumable goods, consumer goods. Clear? For example, separation of a cotton seeds from a cotton balls. It's a ginning. It is as the manufacturing stage. It is a manufacturing process. Separation of a cotton seeds from a cotton balls. Afterwards, such cotton balls used for a spinning purposes. Afterwards, a spinning as a weaving, then the dyeing purposes, then afterwards as a cutting, then stitching, and afterwards when a cloth is ready for a wearing purposes, consumer can utilize that. It is known as the finished good. Industries are basically as a supportive for the growth of any of economy. Those economies of world which are basically emphasizing over the secondary sector, tertiary sector, these are now as the developed economies. But those economies which only as emphasizing, basically as emphasizing over the primary sector, they are lagging behind. These are now presently as the underdeveloped or developing nations of the world. Developing nations of the world. So for improving as economic status of a country, we need as all countries require as a industrial growth. Industrial growth. Industrial revolution began in a European countries around as a 16th century. Afterwards, as an industrialization, improvements bring. And such kind of improvements now as a visualized in a form of a most number of a developed nations are located in a European countries. As compared to the Africa and Asian countries, African and Asian countries mostly as a developed nations are in Europe. So the processes of changing the primary raw materials into the more usable consumer goods is known as the manufacturing. The processes of changing the primary raw materials into useful, valuable products by utilizing machinery, human skills known as the manufacturing. The products obtained are called the secondary sector. I'm again as I'm repeating, the process of changing the primary raw material into more usable and valuable goods by utilizing machines and human skills is known as the manufacturing. The products obtained, such kind of a products which are obtained from as the secondary sector activities or a secondary products, like as a sugar, textiles, shoe, furniture, paper, rubber, tires, automobiles, rails, all these are the examples to which are indicates as a secondary goods, which are based upon as a primary goods, raw materials. Manufacturing or industrialization is the basis of country's economy, should have varied and diversified industrial units. India, like as a country where the vast scope for the industrial growth, because generally as industries are located in such areas which are lagging behind at their previous years, there are the more possibilities for the improvements. Possibilities of improvements in those areas where earlier as industries were not located. These were not set up. Okay. Industries, they are affects the all other activities and brings as the positive change in economy. Industrialization as the important for all economies. Why? Because industries are provide as a more number of a job opportunities, and those people which are getting as a job through which they can improve their living standard. So those economies where the industries are the main source of the livelihood, in such economies people are spending as a high living standard. Second, in such countries as a positive balance of trades are work. Balance of trade means the interrelationship between the imports and exports. So those economies which are emphasizing over the industries, where the industries are generally as a growing, in such economies, positive balance of trade, they generally as work. It means as a more number of the exports to the such countries occur comparatively the imports. In our country, in relation to the industrial growth, there is a negative balance of trade. We are importing as manufactured goods in our country and exporting as a raw materials. As we read in a previous year, India 60% of iron ore directly exported towards as a Japan, North Korea and European countries. If we start to locate our industrial units in our country through which the people they will getting as a jobs, and afterwards the selling of a manufactured goods to the iron and steel industries, then we can earn as a more profit margin comparatively the selling of a raw materials. Clear? Second, as a positive balance of trade. Third, marketing and export of these goods, it will be as a bring as a revenue and a foreign exchange for our country. Fourth one, it will raises the per capita income. Industries will support for the increase in a per capita income, which eradicate the poverty and brings in a socio-economic changes. So through this, as a, all these ways, as a country, it will be as a positively gain through as a growth of industries. The industrialization is the key to development and economic prosperity. India should concentrate more on a manufacturing than on exporting of a raw materials. Raw materials which are selling at a low cost, but as compared to manufactured goods, they are purchased at a high cost. When we will manufacture the goods within our economy, then selling the manufactured goods to the other countries, then we can earn as a good profit margin. Presently, as a Japan, it is as an industrial giant in all over the world, who is a virtually poor in a raw materials, in a natural resources. As per the location of Japan, which is located on a Indo-Pacific tectonic plate, their margins, it has experienced the earthquakes and tsunamis every year. As per the location of Japan, natural resources are not available here. Agriculture is not supportive as per the island country, and their location has not favorable for the existence of natural resources. But still, as Japan is one of the most developed economies. Why? Because they are importing as a materials from other poorer countries, manufacture them through their industrial units, and afterwards of manufactured goods, they are exporting such materials towards other economies of the world. The world's market is appropriately, which is priced as a high quality competitive products, and thus strengthen the economy of the country. Poverty and unemployment, it can be as a removed by the industrialization. When the industries will locate in a country, it will provide as a more number of a job opportunities to the people. Job opportunities and simultaneously in the end, poverty, it will eradicate from a country. In an age of a globalization, at presently as a the concept of a globalization is a fastly developing in all economies, which means as interconnecting of world economies. Globalization means interrelationships between the different countries of the world. India known for the primary goods, agriculture goods, whereas other countries known for as secondary goods. So we are exchanging our materials with the other countries. In the Gulf countries, oil is basically as extracted. So India completing their 60% of a need of a petroleum directly from a Gulf countries of a OPEC, O-P-E-C, oil producing Eastern countries. And in such avers, we are exporting our agriculture goods to the such countries. So that's why I use as an interconnection between economies. Presently as an open market system has working in all the countries. Interconnection between economies. Not any of a country of a world, it can survive as they are independently. Neither as a China, Russia, or nor as the America also. They are also dependent on other countries. For example, as per the existence and the need of America, they need as a human resource, which has largely moving from African and Asian countries towards the America. Human resource, workforce, moving from Asian and African countries towards the America. Presently, if we are seeing as an example of North Korea, which is isolated by the nation as the fast developing concept, India must strive to make the industries more competitive, diversified, and open. So we are the self-sufficient in most of the capital and consumer goods. We must export our product in international market after the manufacturing, neither as a raw materials. This openness will help our industries to produce good quality products at lower cost without losing our grip on market and revenue. As a healthy competition will keep the manufacturers in demand in international market, our biggest asset is skilled, abundant labor at low wages, and this potential should be exploited to achieving the developmental goals. Clear? Contribution of our industries in a national economy, in a GDP of our country is a 17%, 17. 17% contributes as the secondary sector in a GDP of our country. This is as a data related with the 2003. And as compared to this, the other sectors, the primary sector, it contributes also as the lesser, but the job opportunities generated to the primary sector as the more. As the more. Clear? So our chapter is industries. Let's start our chapter. Our chapter, any of an industry, it has basically as influenced by the locational factors. There are two locational factors which are impact over the location of industries, geographical and non-geographical. Geographical and non-geographical. Geographical factors and non-geographical factors. Non-geographical factors. Geographical factors and non-geographical factors. Geographical factors includes as a raw material, land, climate, raw material, land, water, power supply, markets, nearness of markets, growth of means of transport, raw material, power supply, climate, water, labor, all these are the influenced by the geography of an area. Non-geographical factors includes as a capital, government policies, capital and government policies. All collectively, these are responsible for the location of any industry. Now let's start from the first. Any of a industry. Geographical and a non-geographical factors. So the first, land. Any of a industry required as a vast extensive area for its production site. Presently, as a most number of a large scale industries, they are as the more profit gaining industries comparatively the small scale firms. As compared to the small scale industries, the large scale industries. Why? Because in a large scale industries, all the different number of a manufacturing stages are occur in a one industry. For example, when we taking as an example of a Fords, F-O-R-D, Ford. Ford is associated with a vehicles, F-O-R-D. Ford is located in a U.S., in the United States of America. It is as the multinational company. Not only as a one country is responsible for a production, different number of countries of world are associated for a manufacturing of a Ford vehicles. Machinery brought from the Japan, the machine parts of the vehicle brought from the China, from the Russia, which are as a finally assembled in a US. Afterwards, as their cars, they are selling in a world market. So the extensive area required for a location of industries, for which as basically required as a less fertile lands. Industries are needed to locate in areas of a fertile lands of agriculture. Specifically as a land used for industries as the less fertile or a barren lands. Second, raw material. All industries are required as a raw material in a larger quantities. But some of the industries are there which can be as a locate at any part of a country without, which are not influenced by the location of a raw material. These industries are not influenced by the location of a raw material. For example, pharmaceutical industries. Industries which are manufacturing as a medicines, it can be located at any part of a country because their material is a light in weight and smaller in quantities. Such kind of industries are known as a footloose industries. Those industries which can locate at any part and require as raw material in a smaller in quantities and light in weight. These are known as a footloose industries. But as compared to this, the iron and steel industries, they can't be located as a far away from their raw material sites. They have to locate in regions where the raw material available as the nearer to the industries. So raw material as a second factor, which is affecting as a location of industries. Third is climate. Climate is an important factor influencing as growth of industries. Some of the industries are there which require as a hot and moist weather conditions. Hot and humid weather conditions like as a cotton textiles. In cotton textiles generally as a require as a humid weather conditions for strengthening of a thread. If the weather conditions are the drier, under such circumstances, thread breaks. So for which as artificially moist weather conditions, they are making in a industries or either. Industries are located in areas where the moist weather conditions are prevails, means coastal regions. In coastal areas, most number of cotton textiles are located. That's why as a most number of cotton textiles located in a Bombay, Mumbai, Ahmedabad and the coastal parts of Vadodara, Rajkot, Raikot in these regions, Ahmedabad of Gujarat and Maharashtra. But as compared to this, the iron and steel industries, they have to locate in regions where the dry weather conditions are prevails. Because as you familiar, if the moisture present in the air, it will be responsible for the rust. Iron, it will be rusted. So dry weather conditions are desirable for the location of iron and steel industries. So varied form of climatic conditions are influenced the location of a industry in which as a climate as an important factor. Next as a water. So most number of industries require the water in abundance in larger quantities, like cotton textiles for washing and dyeing purposes. In iron and steel industries, thermal power stations, nuclear power stations, water required in larger quantities for cooling purposes. So the water, it should be as a present nearer to the industry. So for which as industries are, industries as generally locate in regions where industries are located in regions where the water available in larger quantities through naturally. Next is the power, regular supply of power. Presently, all the industries are run on the basis of electricity, on a power supply. That's why as industries are located in areas where the power easily available through the thermal power stations, nuclear power stations, or either the hydro power stations, or either industries located in such areas where the coal is easily transported towards as the industries. That's why as the JN Tata decided to set up the India's first iron and steel industry in Jamshedpur because of nearness of water, dry weather conditions of Jharkhand and Orissa, such areas, nearness of the port. Next as a transport, port. Transport is important, one of the another important factors, because after the production, if the goods are not selling in the market, how can the industrialists, they will getting as the profits. So nearness of a market and a well network of a railways and a roadways desirable for a growth of industries. Bringing a raw material from a mining sites towards the industries and afterwards the manufactured goods. These goods has to move towards the markets, for which as a well network of a transport is a desirable. It is as a mandatory for a growth of a any of industry. Labor. Next is the labor. Labor has supported for a growth of industries. Growth of industries. In a different forms of industries, labor required, skilled and unskilled. In large scale industries, as skilled, unskilled, both the labors are required. Both the types of labor required for a production. In a mining sites, as a unskilled labor, and for running of a machines, the skilled labor desirable. So labor also as contributing in a growth of industries. So industries are located where as a such kind of a cheaper labor easily available. Cheaper labor away easily available. If the labor brought from a far away areas, then such labor, it will be as a demand for the more capital, more income for their transportation. So it will be as a not good for the industries. So they try to locate in areas where as a population density is a higher. Where the population is available in abundance in larger quantities and cheaper in form in such areas as industries are generally located. So first land, second labor, third raw material, fourth climate, fifth water, sixth power, seventh market, eighth transport. These are the geographical factors. Till then, any questions? Next are the non-geographical factors. Non-geographical means first as a capital. Capital availability in a locality means support by the government to the banks. It is as a required for a location of industries. Because capital required for a purchasing of a machinery, technology, payment to the laborers, purchasing of a raw materials for which as a labor required in a larger quantities. So industries generally as located in regions where capital available to as the banks as the credit. And second, as a government policies, the favorable government policies are also supportive for the growth of industries. Support for the growth of industries. In some of the governments are there which are not supportive for an industrial growth. For example, as a those garments which are restricted as the foreigners to enter in their localities. Enter in their develop as an agriculture-based economy now as moving towards the small-scale industrial units also. Small-scale industrial units. So keeping in mind of the, these factors, the most appropriate and a profitable site is selected. Industrialization of any area initiates the urbanization and subsequent modernization. Infrastructure facilities intensify the water and power supply, sufficient banking and credit facility, and transport network. Industrialization attracts the labor force. An area becomes as the hub of the activities, generating the diverse employment, developing the service sectors. In short, a center transforms into a town or a city. That's why as the smaller cluster of urbanization develop along the Delhi, which is now as a presently known as a well-developed areas of a Gurgaon and Noida. The industrialization helps in removing the regional disparities and poverty by providing the jobs to people and high living standard. It improves as a living conditions for the people. Our policy should be to diffuse the industrialization to different parts in non-industrial areas. Before of independence, during as a colonial period, during colonial period, at the early phase of a British age in the 18th century, around the 1750s afterwards, mid of the 18th century, at that time as a British policies lead to the de-industrialization in India. Those industries, those small-scale industries, cottage industries, earlier growing in Indian subcontinent, these were ruined due to as a British interference. Most number of raw material directly exported towards the Britain and the manufactured goods sold in Indian markets. Then afterwards, the one century till the mid of a 19th century, 1850s, Britishers started as an industrialization in India. They set up as a such small-scale units in India, which transformed the raw material into the other goods, but such goods they can't be as a consumed by the consumers. These were the unfinished materials. Such materials exported towards Britain and other European countries for a manufacture, and afterwards the final goods were sold in Indian markets at high rates. Then Britishers, they started as a re-industrialization. Those small-scale industries which earlier as affected, now their transformation occurred in the form of a large-scale industries. In that pace, as a Britisher set up as a Tesco in 1907, Tata Iron Steel Company in Jamshedpur in 1907 to complete their such requirements, which mostly as are related with the with their war, arms, ammunitions, uniforms, for which as they set up as a large scale units in our country. So earlier industrial developments during as a colonial period, the industrial development took place in areas like as a Kolkata, Chennai, Mumbai, Delhi, which were known as the what we call to the such places which earlier as a developed by the Britishers in 18th century. Ruhani, raise your hand. Ruhani, she's in a class. Raise your hand. If Ruhani is not there, Karthik, raise your hand. Yes, Ruhani. What we call to such cities, Bombay, Calcutta, Chennai and Delhi, which were developed during the British age, colonial period. Ruhani?
Sir, port cities?
Delhi is a port city. Really? Delhi is a port city. No, metropolitan cities now as a, we are calling to the such areas. Metropolitan means those cities which are having as a population more than the 1 crore. All these cities having as a more than 1 crore of the population as they individually. Mumbai as lies under the world's 7 topmost most populous cities. What term used by the Britishers in relation to the Bombay, Calcutta, Delhi, and Madras, which is now as known as Chennai. These were developed during as a British age. Roll number 9, Ekjot Kundal. Ekjot. Ekjot. Kartik, raise your hand. Kanishka, raise your hand. Yes, Kartik here. Kartik, answer. What term used by the Britishers?
Sir, question repeat karna.
During British age, Britishers developed these four cities at their early phase of their development. Bombay, Calcutta, Madras, and Delhi. At that time, such cities were known as a
colonial cities.
Sorry, repeat it.
Colonial. Sir, bolna nahi aa raha.
Likhkar bata do, type kar do.
Cities.
Were developed at the early phase of the development by the Britishers in India, Calcutta, Madras, Bombay, and Delhi. Because of the most of the facilities required, including as a trading for industrialization, were already present in such areas. That's why the Britishers, they develop as a newer universities afterwards that commission which was called by the Britishers. Then simultaneously, the new industrial hubs developed along the such areas. Kolkata, known for as a jute industries. Delhi, it was for their political importance. Mumbai, Bombay, for the cotton textiles. India's first cotton textile industry located in Bombay. And Chennai, for the